Hello folks, and welcome back to another video. Today we will be diving into Zoom, which is the video conferencing software that I use and could be quite popular now as a way to communicate with you and your team. Now Zoom does a host of things. It does meetings, webinars, conference rooms, phone systems, and also chat as well. So in today's feature, I'm going to show you how I use it for meetings and also live streams as well, which I've recently been using. I'll also go over the pricing plans, we'll start with that, and give you a tour of my account and a few of other settings abilities that you can utilize. So before we dive in, there are different types of pricing on Zoom. There's the basic plan, the pro plan, and the business plan. Now, I was on the free plan for many years, and I'll explain what the free plan includes, but I've recently moved to the pro, maybe as of 6 months ago. The reason why I moved is because it has some capabilities, allowing me to do a few live streams, and also to give me more access to avoid any of the limitations. So on the free plan, you can host up to 100 participants per call, and if you have a group meeting, say above 3 people, you will be limited to 40 minutes per meeting. You can, however, have unlimited one-to-one meetings, and you can have an unlimited amount of meetings a month. In the pro plan, you get all of that. You can also add and bolt on new participants, as well as a meeting duration limit of 24 hours, so there's no limits to the meetings. You can also customize your personal meeting ID, something I'm yet to do, and you also have 1 GB of MP4 or M4A cloud recording storage, as well as a whole host of administration abilities and reporting. Here we are inside of my Zoom account. Now, the reason I like using Zoom over some of the other tools, I previously used Skype quite a lot, and I found that Zoom was much more reliable. The reliability came in the form of meetings barely having any blips, to a point that I actually decided to use for the majority of the time to record my meetings or interviews through podcasts through Zoom because it was so reliable. Now what's cool is if you get sent a Zoom invite, you can join straight away, and if you have it installed, it will naturally open up a bit like Cisco WebEx and also Skype as well. So this is what dashboard you get if you have been invited to a meeting. It will appear up in this sort of like schedule. You can also start a meeting here, join one, also begin sharing your screen straight away, and scheduling a meeting. Now, personally, I've never used the scheduling a meeting tool. I probably will start using it in the near future. Up here, you can go to meetings, and you can see any upcoming or recorded ones. I've never recorded a meeting, but I've actually recorded it to my local storage and I found it pretty good. Now what's cool is you can actually create a personal meeting ID. In this case, this is my personal meeting ID, but you can actually give yourself a specific URL inside of settings, which means that people can actually go on that link every single time. So you don't have to reproduce a link every single time you go through it. I'll start using that with Woven's conferencing tool that they're looking to add. So you can also enable certain features when you're just about to start a meeting, but let's show you inside of each meeting. So when you enter a meeting, you can join with your computer audio. And what's cool is, what I always liked about the software is on that left-hand side, you can automatically change your microphone, your speakers, and also test your speakers. And if you want any additional settings, you can go into audio settings and change anything there. You can also go to those video settings and actually change some of the things. For example, touch up your appearance, hide non-video participants, spotlight my video when speaking, and do a whole host of other minor modifications. Now, there are a bunch of things in settings that I'll jump into a little later, but as a sort of setup, it's quite easy to get things going. And all you have to do to invite someone is press the invite button down at the bottom and press that copy URL. And what's handy is if you have that persistent personal meeting link, it means that they can automatically get what they need to know. You can also connect it to an email provider like Gmail or Yahoo and actually send it on to someone. You can manage your participants down in the bottom, and you can even chat with them as well, which is helpful. For example, if someone's having technical difficulties with their own microphone, you can chat and communicate what the issue may be. You can also share a screen. What I like about the sharing screen abilities is you can share pretty much anything that's on your desktop. So you can also use a whiteboard to demonstrate something, and also you can plug a phone in via AirPlay or via cable. You can also share just a portion of your screen as well as a computer sound only, and also content from a second camera. So for example, if you were demonstrating some of a bit of artwork that you're doing and you had a camera set up on it separately, you can organize that. You also have the ability to share files in Dropbox, OneDrive, Google Drive, and Box. Now, one of the things that I use quite persistently is a record feature. You can click here and you can record the meeting. And what's cool is after the meeting's finished, it will give you a download of that meeting. So instantly start recording. And if you had that pro account, you could record straight to the cloud. There is this new reactions feature, which I haven't used yet. Now inside of the more, if you have a certain setting that you can go to Zoom My Account settings to set up, you can have custom live streaming. And I believe it's on the pro account. You can actually have a custom live stream, and I'll show you how I go about doing that. So when you press custom live stream, you can actually set up a streaming URL and streaming key, which is provided by YouTube Livestream. So you'd copy that into the URL and key areas, and then you'd copy the live streaming page, which is the page that it pre-plans to be released on. So I do this for my live videos on YouTube. And what's cool is I can use Zoom exactly how I would use Zoom. I can share my screen, allowing them to see the end product. And actually, it's fairly seamless if you want a basic live stream setup. You can also live stream on Facebook. That doesn't include Facebook groups. This is something I tried to pull together. You can also live stream directly to YouTube if you wanted to set up that direct integration. But for me, I do like that custom live stream setting ability. You can also stream to Workplace by Facebook, which is a platform, a team communication platform, which is useful to use. Now you can check up in the top left-hand corner about your passwords and your meeting IDs, and you can also see whether your client connection is encrypted. If you want to end a meeting, you can end it for all or just leave the meeting, but you can basically shut the entire meeting down from there. Now inside of the settings, they do have them things like the use of dual monitors, theme settings, as well as show the meeting duration. You can also change some of the chat settings that you may have. For example, the ability to show link previews and also unread messages to appear. Now, one of the settings that people do like is the virtual background settings. So for example, if you wanted to put yourself inside of San Francisco, Zoom will detect the background and you will now have a background. A lot of people have been creating some really funny ones of these on Product Hunt, and you can go ahead and add image or add a video to the background anytime. So if you wanted you sat in the Bahamas, then that's something you can do. I may just do this for my next meeting. You can also choose where you locally store your files, which is perfect. And you can also choose to add, for example, settings like add timestamps, optimize for a third-party video editor, and also keep temporarily recorded files. Now, what's cool as well is you can see your statistics. This is something I believe is only available in the Pro account, but you can see how much use has been taken up from your memory, how much pressure it's putting on your bandwidth, and also any latency issues. Scheduling a Zoom call is pretty easy as well. You can pick the time, invite the right people, and generate all the relevant codes. And you can also connect it up with your Google Calendar, and that's something I've done when I've logged into my Google account. Few more things. Zoom apparently at the moment is removing the 40-minute time limit on basic free accounts for any K-12 schools that have been affected by what is happening at the moment. So you can obviously take advantage of that. This is becoming a really popular tool for students looking to communicate with other teachers, especially in university colleges and even schools as well. So they also provide a video webinar software. So for example, you can host up to 100 attendees, which means that you have an interactive video panelists, and that can be viewed to anyone between 100 to 10,000 view-only attendees. Now, you can also host the controls like muting, unmuting panelists, and also do a Q&A and live stream on the relevant platforms. Apparently, it starts at £32 a month for 100 attendees. Zoom also has a ton of other packages, like an audio-only plan, which start at £100, where you can call any landline, any number, and you'll have no issues. They also have something called Zoom Phone, which is £8 a month per user, and apparently acts as a single app for voice and video and voicemail and messaging and meetings and conferencing. So it allows you to seamlessly make and receive PSTN calls over cellular voice, cellular data, or Wi-Fi connections. So Zoom's available on all devices and provides you with a pretty consistent service, in my opinion. Seems to be the best one out there that I've ever tried, and I will be sticking with it, especially in the future, to record podcasts and interviews. So folks, I hope you enjoyed this overview, and leave a like if you found it valuable, and also please do subscribe if you're brand new, but hopefully you can find as much value as I have found from Zoom. Anyway, folks, a big thank you, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.